If we were to ask, is there an optimal ancestral diet? My answer is no. There's not a singular optimal ancestral diet or human diet per se. And knowing my audience, there's probably a uniform intake of breath and puckering of backsides when I say that. But hang with me here. I'm still in good company. But I just kind of want to reorient the way that we frame a lot of these questions, because I think that some of the ways that we've gone after trying to even ask questions, the hypothesis generation process, has kind of led us down some blind alleys. So I want to point out some cultures, and you guys are, I'm sure, are super familiar with this stuff, but there are quite a number of cultures with diets that work. And by diet, I mean the nutrition that they eat daily, not the thing that they're trying to do after the first of the year. So just so we're clear on that. But we have everything from the Inuit to the Katavans, Okinawan. Many of these people are considered to be in the what's called blue zones. They're really interesting in that they do have some very interesting commonalities, largely whole unprocessed foods, a host of lifestyle characteristics that are very uniform and consistent. We're going to talk about that more at the end of this whole kind of discussion. But what's really oddly missing is uniformity in macronutrients. You look at the Katavans on the one hand, and they're upwards of a 70% carbohydrate diet, mainly from tubers, and then the Inuit could not be more different than that. But pretty uniformly, what they have as far as outcomes, which I think is the thing that we need to focus so much more on, both clinically and also from our research perspective, which again, Dr. Eid was talking about that just a few minutes ago. When we focus on the outcomes, when we look at these kind of blue zone populations, these pre-Westernized populations, they're largely free of Western degenerative disease. They die from something eventually, and it usually is something like heart attack or stroke or something like that, but it happens much, much later in life, and they have what's called a compressed morbidity curve. So they tend to stay quite healthy, and then they die.